Everybody, I hope you're well. I'm going to share with you today some wisdom that I have gleaned from my holiday read, which is a book called Sapiens by, oh, I can't remember his name, Habari something, no. Anyway, look up Sapiens, it's a really good read. Sheds a whole new perspective on life, basically. It's effectively the history, a brief history of humankind. And, as ever, there's some lessons that I thought might be useful to share with you guys. The first one is with regard to technique. Now, I know I've done a few posts about this before, but we are designed to run as humans, and so, like our cavemen and women ancestors, would have embodied that ideal technique. Because of the lifestyles that they've evolved to lead. And one of the lines in the book said how Homo sapiens, back in the day, would have just tried to be as light on their feet as possible, so as not to impact the environment around them, but also from a hunting perspective. If you've got someone that's really heavy on their feet, then it's going to scare away the prey. And when I sort of think about some of the runners in my group, not me, obviously, no, I'm joking, I can improve my technique still, but yeah, particularly the kids, they just slap their feet down. There's just no sense of going after prey, basically. But I think that's a really useful thing to bear in mind as you are trying to run, and even just move generally in life. And I think this is where I can benefit in particular. Because I do slouch a little bit, and I know I do slap my feet a little bit when I'm walking. And whereas if I just try to sort of have the hunter-gatherer mindset, it has made a bit of a difference. So it's quite a steep walk down and up to the beach from our clifftop resort here, maybe me. And so as I'm going back up the steps, I'm now sort of trying to think about just that alignment and the lightness, and it definitely makes a difference. Incredibly so, really. And it's just through a slight alteration, say in mindset and in posture. Also, when walking along the beach, it's hard work in the soft sand. But if you just think about having those smaller, lighter steps, then, and not sinking into it, you know, just kind of floating along the top, then it's a lot more efficient, and just feel like I'm using my calves a lot more as well. On a slightly vain note perhaps as well, I am conscious sometimes, I sort of see the approach of myself or like film myself where I'm not in the hunter-gatherer posture, and I have quite a bit of a double chin. From now on, I'm going to be looking down my nose during these videos. you get the point anyway. If you sit how you're designed to, then you look better as well. Extra bonus material. Posture. And so not just in running, as I say, in everyday life when you're walking around, when you're sitting as well. And I know I've mentioned this a few times, in various other posts, but I spent a long weekend working with Wilson Kipketer, former world 800 meter record holder, and he did embody that hunter-gatherer like technique. And one of the key points he made was that it wasn't just when he was running, it was in everyday life as well. And so something whereby I have noticed a bit of a difference as well is even just as I'm sat on my computer, and just having that sense of lightness and openness, it makes life more enjoyable, actually. I just feel a bit more kind of open-minded as I'm working somehow, and just relaxed. Again, my back doesn't get quite so stiff. And it does make me think of how I saw really good physio recently who talks about the spine being like the wheel of life, so the spinal fluid that circles around the spine. It kind of is what energizes you. And so, as you sit up with a posture aligned and vertebrae aligned, then you're much more likely to have that free-flowing wheel of life and lots of energy. Point one. I'll try and keep this to a bit more succinct. Fear, hunter-gatherers, we kind of think that they were really fearful of like being eaten by lions and things like that, but actually the author tends to say that that probably wasn't the case, and in fact because they didn't rely on just a few sparse crops like as what became the case in the agricultural revolution, they were much more relaxed about life and gathering food, and the evidence showed they probably work about 5 hours a day, something like that, and then the rest of the time was just relaxing and socialising. Less fear, which again I think can be quite important for an athlete, in terms of not stressing and not getting tense, and just focusing on what you can do in that moment rather than projecting too much into the future. So recovery as well, by not working too hard, not doing too much just in case sort of thing, just having faith in what you're doing. There's a picture in the book where it shows an Egyptian, and that was during the agricultural revolution, and he's all sort of stooped and he's whipping this like bull carrying a plough, and that was the author's way of saying that he was likely to be tired and overworked, which can quite often be the case in our modern society today. There's a lot of instances of overworking, overstressing, and then our stooped postures, partly due to fatigue, but partly due to the keyboard warrior, I guess, as well. I know it's sort of easier said than done, in terms of letting go of the fear and everything. But just from a general life perspective, as well as from just trying to perform well in athletics, then I think it can be good to have the hunter-gatherer mindset. And just to keep reinforcing it as well, so it becomes second nature. Right, I'll leave it there. Take care. Thanks for watching. Bye.